Welcome back to the Relaxing Ghost channel here on YouTube. Today, we got Superstar Shakeup 2019. The results are in. Who went to Raw? Who went to SmackDown? We got a lot of changes. So let's get right into this, guys. Before we get into it, take some time and subscribe. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below, who were some of your favorite moves here, or would you have done things differently? Were you expecting some different changes here? I'm indifferent when it comes to the Superstar Shakeup because they don't really follow it anyways. I like the old traditional draft. Right now it doesn't seem like a big deal, but you just randomly have guys showing up on Raw, showing up on SmackDown. It just seems, completely random, like anyone can show up. And that's the thing I don't like about it. I like the big draft lottery they did a couple of times. I like the, Superstar Draft, and also the WWE, regular draft, where they do a big shuffle and then the big superstar pops up on the Titantron and things like that. Or they pick a ball out of the roller. Someone's name is in a ball and they got a new superstar. So let's run down these names quickly. For Raw, excuse me, for Monday Night Raw, April 15th, we had over 15 superstars joining Raw, including some NXT talent. There was in total 17. I'm only going to count 15 here. You could count 16, I guess. But first up here was The Miz. The Miz, I have no problem with him joining Raw. Second and third were Andrade and Zelina Vega. Again, no problem there. I like Andrade quite a bit, former NXT champion. I expect big things from Andrade. Fourth, they actually did a count Ricochet and Aleister Black. I'm not going to really count those guys since they have been on the main roster now for a couple of months, since February. So I'm not really going to count those guys. Next up was one of the more controversial moments of Raw. Changing the War Raiders name to the Viking Experience. Not a fan of this at all. A lot of people were pissed off. So we got the NXT Tag Team Champions on Monday Night Raw. I'm guessing they'll lose the titles fairly soon. Next up here, we had Rey Mysterio. Again, no big deal. I think Rey Mysterio is better off on SmackDown. Next two picks here were the Usos and Naomi. The 10th pick here, Eric Young. I'm actually really happy to see Eric Young in a prominent pick here. It's weird because sometimes these picks can do a lot and sometimes they don't, end up being anything, they could just, oh, you're on Raw now, and then they never use them or things like that. It's weird how they do these shakeups. So I'm happy to see Eric Young. The next official pick, I guess, would have been EC3. But again, he's been on TV since December, where they did, all these coming soon vignettes and things like that, where they drafted about six guys at the same time. Up next from 205 Live, Cedric Alexander. Again, no big deal here. I like Cedric quite a bit, so happy to see him on Raw. And Then we have Lars Sullivan finally making his WWE Raw debut. We'll get into him in a little bit, but I was happy to finally see him make the debut. Again, he was a part of those original six coming soon back in like December or whatever, November, December. And then again, Lacey Evans, she's been on Raw for quite a while now, so no big deal there. And finally, AJ Styles, the face that runs the place, is on Monday Night Raw. So overall, I think there's a lot of really good stuff happening here. They did shuffle things up quite a bit. So, you know, my top picks of the Raw are going to be Eric Young, AJ Styles, and the Usos. Honestly, I'm digging War Raiders quite a bit. I think they need to put the axe down on that Viking experience. The next night, SmackDown, April 16th. They had a total of 8 picks throughout the night, and then they did 4 picks on WWE.com. First thing of the night was Finn Balor, the Intercontinental Champion. Finn Balor is now on SmackDown. It is rumored that Samoa Joe is supposed to be on Raw. So I guess we'll find out Monday night if he's on Raw with the United States Championship. I think that's a good move, Joe on Raw. He has been on Raw before, right? But putting Joe back on Raw, it doesn't really make any sense to me. I think he was a better fit on SmackDown. You know, apparently, you know, he was sick or injured or I don't know. There's too many rumors to really confirm anything at this point. Second pick for SmackDown, I guess it's a pick, but Ember Moon, not really a fan, but whatever. Third pick was Bayley. And here's the stupidest part about Bayley's move to SmackDown. She just lost the tag titles. She comes to SmackDown and she says, I'm done being a tag team. I'm going to try doing a singles or whatever the hell she said. Straight away, they have her in a tag team match. How stupid is your creative team? Don't even let her cut that promo then. Just say, oh, Bayley's on SmackDown. She's going to be in a tag team match tonight. WWE creative makes no sense. There's no logic in WWE creative. Next up was another NXT call-up, Kairi Sane. Big fan. Happy to see her on SmackDown. Fifth pick, again, Lars Sullivan. Made another big impact on SmackDown here the next night. I'm guessing Lars will officially be on SmackDown. On Raw, he took out Kurt Angle. And on SmackDown, I honestly forget who he took out. Seventh and the final pick. They were promoting this, SmackDown's biggest, whatever, call-up in history, whatever the hell they called it. Out comes Elias. You know, out comes Mr. McMahon. This is, kind of Mr. McMahon trolling everyone. And then out comes Roman Reigns. The big dog is now on SmackDown. So, I'm happy to see Reigns on SmackDown. You know, just get him away from Monday Night Raw for a while. Maybe he could build some momentum back on SmackDown. Oh, Buddy Murphy. I actually skimmed over Buddy Murphy. 205 Live. Again, another 205 call-up. So, he just lost a Cruiserweight title. I think Buddy Murphy, Finn Balor for the IC title could work. I think Lars Sullivan and Roman Reigns could work. Let's get these guys some big-time matches on SmackDown and over the next few pay-per-views. Offline, or after the show, WWE.com posted the full shake-up results, and they did also throw in 4 more names to SmackDown. Mickie James, Liv Morgan, Chad Gable, and Apollo Crews. So, four guys. I'm not the biggest fan of Apollo. He has something there. He's got to find a voice, though. Chad Gable, sort of the same thing. Great worker. Not the best on the mic. I wasn't a fan of his team with Bobby Roode, though. So it's great to see them split up. You know, Bobby Roode is a singles wrestler. He can be in a faction. But the tag team with Chad Gable, I just wasn't a fan of it. And Liv Morgan, I think she was better off in the Riot Squad. So overall, I'm pretty satisfied with what they did here. And, you know, these shakeups really don't mean much, because Money in the Bank will probably have a interpromotional match. Survivor Series, it's Raw versus SmackDown. The Royal Rumble, Raw versus SmackDown. There's always guys going back and forth from Raw to SmackDown, especially the McMahons here. So let me know your thoughts on the shakeup. Did things turn out the way you wanted? What are a couple more moves you would have done? Honestly, I'm pretty happy they switched up the IC and US titles. Finn Balor, I'm really happy to see him on SmackDown. I think we can see Finn Balor versus Roman Reigns, maybe. Honestly, I think I would have kept Bayley on Raw, though. There's just more to do for her there. And with the SmackDown and Raw women's titles being with Becky Lynch, it doesn't look like she's going to be getting any sort of title shot in the near future. So overall, I'm kind of satisfied with what they did. Comment down below, guys. We'll talk to you later. Peace.